Hi guys, welcome to Bib's Life and the US.
Okay, it's Tuesday, 28th in the nosebleed section. If he's behind stage with Trump, he is a cancer. Can you see right there? It's insanity. Pure insanity. I wanted it to expand in a major war. Probably with the Russians. A million have burned for their life. Millie actually go to Ukraine, and what they're talking about is trying to get Zelensky to stop defending Bakhmut, to besiege there, and give up the peace offensive, prepare for a massive spring offensive. This is meant to be a massive spring offensive, focus on maneuver warfare, tank armored warfare, where the Ukrainians would go and try to retake Crimea. It's so wonderful, it's so important. This is really incredible. He's been away from holding these cities in the east, and trying to stop the Russian continuing to eastern Russia speaking Ukraine. And actually, with tanks, prepare for a massive maneuver warfare offense. Aims to take back Ukraine. You're in the agreement right there. There's no offering. And in between, you heard the FBI's got a spy who was part of the integral part of the Trump-Russia hoax. And tells the family that they got lucky to get to, including they think claiming the highly classified material that was given to Biden. The special counsel part of this, all you did was look at this. Dropped everything up. Everything else was just a slight this email that was in the laptop of them. It's in the laptop of them. It clearly comes off a classified briefing. I find out 2 days before the 2014. Let's get the time to get the time. You guys have been hard-loaded when Davis, who was hacked all days. Now, I'll start with Monica. Monica, you were one of the great geopolitical thinkers. You were very close to President Nixon, who was probably one of the smartest of all time. But you're also a senior executive for President Trump in the Treasury Department. You see it going on throughout the world. It's been going on the daily kind of real process. It's been getting metastasized. Give us your assessment on the investigations you see, the classified documents, the crimes of the Biden. And right now, and what we didn't have time to put in, and they don't have the corruption. You have the military period, all the police report that they put on, guys in the helicopter crash. Again, all the internal security forces say he dies in an accident, quote unquote. Now, all the number one priority in Ukraine, the super number one priority, is just the anti-corruption. They're finding guys left and right on a new anti-corruption push. Monica Crowley, make it make sense for us now.
Okay, I'm also President Steven. Thank you for having me this morning. Look, whenever we talk about the regime, the deep state, and the multi-front war, that it is a multi-front assault against the United States, you have to keep in mind that it's all the peace. There are a lot of moving parts here, but they're all running in the same direction. They're all moving in the same direction. Okay, so let's just stipulate that. Number two, let's stipulate that Joe Biden is the most corrupt president we have ever had, and it's not your case. Let's also stipulate that he and his son, Hunter Biden, and one of his brothers, James Biden, they are the most black man that people are facing here. And the fact that this man is now the president of the United States and the commander in chief, making decisions about our national security and foreign policy, perhaps introducing American citizens to the United States, is completely outrageous and totally unacceptable. So most of the United States side of the community now goes into Hunter Biden, the classified documents, scandal, and Ukraine, because.
Okay, bye everyone, and don't forget to subscribe below and thumbs up to our channel and check out our Bib's Closet in HCEB and make curry, and also check out our beautiful decor in HCEB. Bye bye guys, see you to the next video. God bless you all. Bye.